Good day guys, this is another video on MTS shortcuts with Olasende Faith. Okay, today we are going to be treating partial fractions, the shortcuts to partial fractions. And I know most of you would be thinking, how on earth would there be a shortcut for partial fraction, since most of the in the previous videos we have been working with basically options that are like figures, 1 b is 2 and the like. So we've been working with them. And partial fraction is kind of somehow different, but then it has shortcuts. Okay, let's get started. So I want to believe we already understand partial fraction, because the understanding is also important. It is from the understanding that we are going to get the shortcuts. Okay, just like as we know, partial fraction is, for example, you have 2 all over 4 and you're trying to break it into its partial fractions. Like, what are things that what were the fractions that were added together to give this 2 over 4? So for example, 1 over 4 and 1 over 4 gives 2 over 4. So you've broken it into its partial fraction. But the difference here is that instead of it just being 2 like this, it will be having x, a variable in it. That's when you see questions like 10 minus 2x all over x minus 3 x minus 1. So you'll be told to break this into its partial fractions. And from what you have been taught is this one would carry a variable a, plus the other one would carry a variable b, and then you simplify, you multiply, and yes that is correct. But we're not doing that here. We're not doing that time wasting step. We're not doing it here. So let me supply options. So for this question, the options are: number one, 2 all over x minus 3 minus 4 all over x minus 1. B, 3 all over x minus 3 plus 1 all over x minus 1. Then C, 2 all over x minus 3 minus 1 all over 1 minus x. Okay. D, 2 all over 3 minus x minus 1 all over 1 minus x. Okay, now in this kind of question, first and foremost, I would tell you to check through for the denominator. Now, because this is x minus 3 is not the same as 3 minus x, isn't it? So this one and this one, they are out of it. Why? Because you have 1 minus x here, you have 3 minus x, and the in this place is x minus 3 x minus 1. So C and D, they're already out of it. So the option, the answer is between A and B. So firstly, let's try A. Now what would you do to verify this? I'll tell you that you should put a value as x. Pick any number small enough that you can quickly work with, and the number must not give you 0 at the denominator. For example, your best number I tell people to pick is 1, but if I put 1 here, it becomes 1 minus 1. This place becomes 1 minus 1, and that's 0. You don't need 0 as the denominator. The numerator can have 0, but you don't want it as the denominator. So let us move to the next one, which is 2. So putting 2 in any of these places won't give us that kind of problem. So let's work with 2. So the number I've picked is 2. Now let's use 2 to represent x. You first do it in the question. So that's 10 minus 2 times 2, 4 all over, this is 2 minus x minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1. So So at the end of the day, you have 6 all over minus 1, which is same as minus 1, minus 6 all over 1, and the same as minus 6. Okay, now this one is like a test number. It's like a test number. You keep it somewhere. Now you're going to put that same 2 which you used, you put it in the options one after the other. That's 2 all over, this one becomes minus 1, minus 4 all over 1. So let's find the LCM. Minus 1 down here, this is minus 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1 in 1 is minus 1, times this one becomes plus 4, which is 6 over minus 1, and it is minus 6. So this one gives the same thing as what the question gave. So that means A is the answer. I'm going to go all over again. Okay, this is the question. X 10 minus 2x all over x minus 3 x plus 1. Now just like I wrote this on to explain the process of assuming you're doing it normally, then you would have done it this way, but then this one is time wasting. Okay, now you have the option, just like I told you, the options, the answer is there in the option. You just need to locate it. And how do you locate it? We are just going to use the knowledge of mathematics to counter it. That's just it. Okay, now I said first and foremost, remember x minus 3, here you have x minus 1, here you have 1 minus x, which is different. It's very wrong, because x minus 1 is not the same as 1 minus x. Same with this side. So that means automatically c and d, they are out of the equation. They are out of the equation. So it is left with these two. Now how do we get the answer out of this? Now I told you, you are going to pick one number, just pick any number, and I always advise to pick one, but you must check if that one that you are picking will not give zero as the denominator. In this case, it will give zero. If I put one as x here, it will give zero, so I shouldn't use it. I move to the next one, which is two. Now if I put two here, it will not give zero, so fine, we're good to go. Now you're going to put that two in the question first. You put it in this question, 10 minus 2x. Well, you put it there. After putting it, I got 6 minus 6. You can try it, minus 6. Now, this is a test number. This is what you're using to test whether your answer is correct or not. Now, that same 2 that you put in the question, put it in the answers one after the other. Now, as I put two as x here, and also put 2 as x here, I got 2 over minus 1 minus 4 over 1, and completing it, I got minus 6. So it's same as what I got when I put it in the question. So that is the answer. Now I'm trying another question before I round off partial fraction. So this method, this shortcut is valid. It doesn't really matter how bulky or how big or how large, because there are some partial fraction questions that are very large. Like I can tell you that they are very, very large. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't care. No matter how large it is, it works for everything. So I can tell you that you guys are safe with this. You just have to be fast. You have to be smart. And I can tell you that it saves time. It saves time a lot, a whole lot. Even if you are slow with doing the addition and everything, it saves time. The time you would have used when solving it manually, it would have saved it for you. It would have saved a lot of time for you. So now then C is x minus 5 minus 3 all over x minus 2, then d is 4 all over x minus 1 plus 5 all over x minus 2. Okay, this is another question, so we're going to go straight into using the shortcuts, and that will be so. Remember I told you, pick one so that it won't stress you when converting it into a fraction. Pick one, But then if one gives you zero in the denominator, use another number. Let's try one. 1 plus 7. Remember I told you first put it in the question. Now 1 minus 7 plus 10. Now what do you have? 8 all over. This is minus, this is 4. 8 all over 4, and it is same as 2. Okay, now we have this. Let's try. This is the test. This is the test number. Now let's see whichever one gives this. Now picking the first option, 2 all over minus 4 minus 3 all over 1 minus 1 minus 3 all over minus 1. Okay, now this one is 1 over. Okay, let's just do it directly. Let's not waste time. Now minus 4. 4 minus, so that's 2. 1 times the 2 on top is still 2. And minus 1 in minus 1 in minus 4 is 4 times, that's 12. Now 2 minus 12, that's minus 10 all over minus 4. Okay, minus 10 all over minus 4 is not the answer. The next one is 1. Let me come to this side. The next one is 1 all over, putting x as 1, that's minus 1 plus 2 all over. Okay, this one gives 0. It is definitely not the answer because the option did not give us 0. Not the, because the denominator here didn't give us 0, so this one should not give us 0 at any space and time. Okay, let's go to the C, the next question, next one. So I'm going to clean this. Now the next one has 4 all over minus 4 minus 3 all over minus 1. So that is what? 1 minus 1 plus 3, that is 2. And it is the same as the test, which is also 2. So that means the answer is C. I hope we all understand how to solve partial fractions using the shortcuts. You can, just like I said, you can use it for any kind of partial fraction as long as you have the options. And please and please, this is just to help you guys do well in your exams and tests. Do not neglect the real knowledge due to the fact that you already know the shortcuts. Please know the proper one, and as well you can know the shortcuts. Both of them in the long run will help you. Thank you very much. I remain Olasende Faith. Bye.